going on, my friends? Cubs fan Han here for another Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes video. And my friends, today's video is going to save all you new players out there from making 10 critical mistakes that all new players make. Now, as I talk about this, I want to be clear. This is not just going to benefit new players. This is something that's going to either help you old players remember the mistakes you made and let me know what those are down in the comments below, or avoid making some of these mistakes now. So everyone stay tuned as we go through this. And I want to call out my patrons. Big special thanks to them who helped me put this video together. I've been playing this game for a very long time, and I just, you know, some of the new players just are experiencing things I have never experienced. And so I wanted to tap into some of their expertise to put this list together. And so they absolutely helped me get these 10 mistakes together. And we're going to talk through 10 of them and talk about how to avoid making them. So without any further ado, let's get to number 10. And number 10 is wasting crystals. This is a big one, my friends. Crystals in this game are your lifeblood. You need to be careful with how you prioritize and spend your crystals in the game. Now, the main place that you're going to see a lot of options to spend crystals are in weekly shipments and in the regular shipments tab. Weekly shipments, there's going to be a lot of good deals there. You're probably going to want to spend them there, mostly if you're a pay-to-play player. And there's a big difference between free-to-play and pay-to-play in the beginning game, especially nowadays. We're going to talk a little bit more about that as we go. But one of the worst areas, in my opinion, you can spend crystals is on character shards, mostly because a lot of these characters are available elsewhere. Kylo Ren on Mass is a great example. You could waste 1,280 crystals on Kylo Ren Unmasked when you can find him in an early Cantina node where you can also get a ship. This character is very easy to farm. Some of these characters are available in stores where you can get them, which is very easy. Some of them are just available on hard nodes, like obviously you've got Droidica, Shore Trooper. Here's the TIE Silencer, or TIE Slicer as I used to call it. this one's available on the same note as Kylo Ren. They got them in here for crystals, so just watch out for that. You're going to want to really hoard your crystals and be careful with how you spend them. Somewhere else you're probably going to want to avoid spending them is on the sim tickets. Find other ways to get sim tickets. There's other creative ways to do that. The gear tends to be a good deal, both here and in the weekly shipments, so I would keep your eye on that, especially if you want to buy like this Mark 9 Fabri-Tech, 25 of those. This is one of the better deals in the game if you need those. The same rate comes in for the Mark 12 biotech, let's see, what is it? Mark 8 biotech implant. The salvage for that, pretty low crystal spending for that, so it's something to keep in mind. So be careful with how you spend your crystals, my friends. All right, let's get to number 9 on the list. It is not joining raids. Now, you're going to need to be in a guild, and when you're in a guild, you do not want to miss the raids. It's something that it's easy to take for granted, especially at the beginning. It can be overwhelming. There's a lot to do in this game, but at least at a minimum, make sure you get in there and join the raid. Hit the join button, because zero damage is better than no damage, and if that kind of doesn't make sense. But what I mean by that is if you join, you're going to post to zero. If you don't join, you're not going to post anything. You're not going to get any rewards. And especially at the beginning game, these rewards you get in here, even at the low tier levels, a lot of this is going to be stuff that you're going to find ways to use. For end game players, a lot of this gear, it takes a while before you run into a pull on raids that's actually meaningful to you. But at the beginning, almost all of them are going to be usable pretty early on. So don't miss your raid joining. All right, let's get to number 8 on our list. Number 8 is not understanding how the 600 works. Now, I'm actually a little bit ashamed to admit that I did not figure out how the 600 worked until probably a year and a half into this game. I thought, my impression was, I wasn't really paying attention to what was going on, but the 600, this is under guild activities, and I thought it was spending energy in dark battles. Okay, I need to go do that, and I just kind of do that. What I didn't realize is that this personal raid tickets is a completely different contribution that is just energy and cantina energy. That energy that you need to spend 600 of is just these two right here. Your cantina energy and your regular energy. This is part of my routine. Every day when I first get to the game, I come here to Energy. I buy 3 refreshes. It's 50 crystals each, and then that helps me get my 600. Another part of that is to make sure that you're not missing your refreshes, which come 3 times a day at noon, 6, and 9, depending on where your time zone is. That's where it should portion to, or if you've moved, it might be a different time. Those are going to be here in your daily activities. Let's see here. Right now I've got mine available, so I didn't miss it there. I got 45 Cantina Energy, some Mod Energy, and some regular energy, and I haven't got those yet. I still need to do the rest of my daily activities. So make sure you do not miss your 600 and understand how it works. You just need to spend 600 of Cantina Energy and regular energy combined. All right, let's get to the next one. Number 7 on the list is chromium packs are not your friend. Buying too many chromium packs can really work against you in this game. And I'll tell you a little bit why. In the early game, when we were all playing this, when it first started, chromium packs were not that bad. But right now, I just feel like there's so many characters in this game. The percentage has just gone down so much to get something meaningful from chromium packs. I would personally lean more towards the hyperdrive bundle if you're gonna spend, that many crystals on a mega chromium pack. It's not really that much more to go for the hyperdrive bundle if you're pulling chromium packs left and right, and that gets you the guaranteed characters that you need. We'll talk a little bit more about the hyperdrive bundle here in a bit. But if you look at the mega pack, I could get Lando. There's not really a ton of use for Lando. Mace Windu, bad character. A lot of these characters are just not, you got Jawas in here. It's nice. Eeth Koth is in here. How many times are you going to hit buy for 2,520 crystals and get something you don't need? Whereas in the hyperdrive bundle, you're getting something you know. Well, my philosophy with spending crystals in this game, I don't like spending crystals on RNG. RNG spending is going to be a must for like farming nodes, but even then, you know what character you're getting. It might decrease based on how many shards you pull at once, but at least you know that's the character that I'm going for. Chromium packs, it's totally up in the air. You might get something you have no use for. In fact, the RNG is probably going to work against you every time, more likely than not to get you something you don't need. So try to focus spending in areas that benefit you and you know benefit you. Even if you might not get as much as you want, you know you're at least getting something that you want. All right, let's get to number 6 on the list, and that is farming characters just because you like them. This one makes me sad. And the reason it makes me sad is because I'm a big fan of Galaxy of Heroes being a place for you to fan out. But ultimately, a lot of these characters just aren't very good that should be. Mace Windu is at the top of the list. I mean, we've been asking for a rework for Mace for a long time. And right now, if you went all in on Mace at the very beginning, it might be nice to have this guy farmed out because you like him. He's just not going to... he's not going to do much for you. There's a lot of other characters that fit into this category. Mace is one of those. So I would just recommend, paying attention to your guild. Talk to some friends. Pay attention to our videos to find out who's going to be the wisest to farm. Still find characters that you like. You might choose, I like Night Sisters. Okay, Night Sisters are usable. So that's a faction you might go for pretty early on. But if you want to just, you like Jawas, go for Jawas. Very limited use. So just be intelligent with how you farm. Don't always just farm with your heart. But if you don't care to have any competitive edge ever in this game, then sure, go ahead, max out Mace Windu. Go bananas, I don't care. All right, let's talk about number 5 on the list. Number 5 is maxing out everyone. Now, this is a resource management game. And when you max out too many people at once, you're going to drain your resources and dilute your effectiveness. So let's talk about that a little bit. Right now, I have got, 6, 7, 8 characters in my favorites right now. That's a lot. However, one of them shouldn't really be here. General Kenobi, I just kind of got him there because I got him to gear 13 recently. I just kind of like looking at him. I need to get his relic up, but right now I'm focused on relics for Malak. So Malak is there for relics. Padme and Nest are there for gear 13. I'm working on their gear 13 gear. That's where my energy farming is going. Newt is there because just these two gear pieces are only... all I need from them is found in shipments. And so... or in, like, guild store, shard store. And so I'm only farming those there. And then Shock, Battle Droid, and Arc Trooper, I am just farming with energy. Arc Trooper's kind of on pause right now until I get Malak to Relic 7. And so that's kind of how I've got my focus spread right now. You're going to want to have at max one team in here at once. Right now, it's kind of a conglomerate right now because I've got so many teams. I'm just kind of... getting a couple specific characters, but at the beginning game, focus on one team at a time best you can. If you focus on too many factions at once, you're going to burn through your credits, you're going to burn through your gear, and you're going to have a lot of characters that aren't good. You want to have a few characters that are great at the beginning, especially when you start getting into arena. So, food for thought. Be careful. Have focused farming. Don't spread yourself too thin. All right, let's get to number four on the list. We have got the Hyperdrive Bundle. Now, I'm not going to say that it's a mistake not to buy the Hyperdrive Bundle, but I'm kind of going to say that at the same time. Let me tell you what I mean. It depends on what kind of player you're going to be. And if you are going to be comfortable spending on this game, in my humble opinion, the first place you should spend is now the Hyperdrive Bundle. This is still a bit new to us, but what this does is it gives you so many character shards, so many, several legendary characters, and can catapult you in arena very quick. If you are concerned about being competitive in squad arena and you do not buy the Hyperdrive Bundle, you're going to have to really, really shelf your desire to be competitive in squad arena for probably at least a year, maybe more, because the people who do buy it are just not going to be able to, you're not going to be able to compete with them. And so I would say it's a mistake to not plan what you're going to do about that Hyperdrive Bundle. And if you have not seen the Hyperdrive Bundle, it is extremely packed with stuff. It gives you guaranteed 5-star characters. All of these characters, 5 stars. A full Night Sister fact. And this is also something else to talk about. Is this going to set you pretty nicely for Grand Arena early on? Both for ships and for this. It's going to set you immediately to level 85. That's going to be hard to compete with at the beginning. It's going to give you all of these resources. Zetas, Omegas, ship materials, energy, lots of gear, including Kyrotech. And it's also going to give you access to everywhere in the game, basically. So, look, you need to plan what you're going to do with a Hyperdrive Bundle. I don't want to tell every free-to-play player out there that you're going to be screwed, because it's just going to take longer than it used to. But if you're going to spend money on this game, I highly recommend you consider the first place being the Hyperdrive Bundle, because if you don't and you start spending in other areas, those areas are going to be so much less effective. If you end up spending $100 on this game and you didn't spend it on the Hyperdrive Bundle, you made a huge mistake, is pretty much what this comes down to. All right, let's get to number three on the list. We have got not finding a good guild. Now, as you start this game, something I want to explain to you is that you need to find a guild that matches your play style. Whether that's competitive, whether that's hardcore, whether it's casual, whether it's completely laid back, you need to find a guild that matches you. If you are holding your guild back, you need to find a more casual guild. If you're the workhorse in your guild and everyone else is slacking, nobody's communicating, you need to find a new guild. You do not owe anything to your current guild. You need to find a guild that matches what is best for you. And hopefully that's the guild that you're in right now, and this isn't this doesn't matter, but make sure you find a good guild. There's a lot of resources to help you with that. You can go to Reddit. There's a guild recruiting thread. You can come on my Discord server. I got a link down below in the description. A lot of people are there from other guilds you can meet. You can ask around. Lots of resources to find a guild that matches your playstyle. And there's a lot of rewards that you miss out on, especially guild currency, guild events, guild currency from raids, guild event tokens from territory battles. You need to be in a guild that's moving at your pace if you're going to be competitive in the game. All right, let's get to number two on the list, neglecting mods. Oh my gosh, guys. This is overwhelming, but mods are everything in this game. I'll give you an example right now. My Bastila of Fallen might be the exclusive reason I am competitive in my arena right now. At least why I'm comfortable. Because I've farmed some crazy speed mods. I've got her super fast. And because of that, she goes first in almost every battle. And I'm able to get, if you're not familiar with the character, because you're a new player, basically the debuffs you get up from her early in the battle, whoever gets them up first has a huge advantage in the battle. If I had not been focusing on mods the entire time, there's no way this would happen. So focus on them early. I could make a whole video on how to focus on mods. I won't talk about all of that right now because we'll be here for another 30 minutes. But I'll link a few down in the description below, some good important mod guides. But whatever you do, make sure you do not neglect mods. Learn how to use them, especially if you want to be really competitive in this game. Farm them every day and equip them to your characters. The devs once shared a shocking stat of how many people don't use mods in this game, and it's way too high. Learn mods, use them, farm them. All right, let's get to the next one on the list. We have got number one, the number one mistake people make in this game as early players. Not finding your arena. Now, what I mean by this is finding your arena shard mates. You have got all of these people in your arena, and they are coordinating whether you know it or not. You can see here, all of these people up here we're loading are people that I know, most of them. Some of them we don't know. And the way this works is the people that know each other, some people have problems with this, I'm not going to debate that here. If you have a problem with it, fine. This is just the way the game has been working for a long time. That's neither here nor there. But what you do is you learn when everyone's payouts are so that you can battle up and not hit people who have payout coming up and hit the people who've already had their payout so that you kind of maximize the crystal gain for everyone. Now, I just realized I wasn't showing my game, so we'll go over there. So here's the people in my shard who I'm coordinating with. If you do not get in touch with your arena shard early, the day may come that they no longer allow anyone in. I've got personal opinions about this. I don't like shutting people out, but the reality of this game is that that's what happens. So if you are not one of the first people in there, you risk coming to a point where you are competitive, you want to get at the top of the arena, and now you are the outsider, and all of them are trying to keep you out of the arena. So if you get in touch with them soon, which you can, easy way to do it is to go in, find a couple people that are at the top. I know this guy right here. I can go in here, I can message him, and you know, ally request him, message him, or whatever. Maybe they've got messages turned off, so find somebody else that you can message and get in touch with them. Find your shard, find their Discord server, do it fast. Because if you don't, you might miss the boat. All right, everyone, that is the full list of mistakes new players make in this game. Let me know what you guys think about the list. What are some other mistakes that new players make and that you made? Especially, I'm interested to hear, what mistakes did you make when you started this game? I made basically all of these, except for the hyperdrive bundle wasn't around, and so, but I would have made, I spent up to $100 segmented over several months, and if the hyperdrive bundle would have been around, that would have been probably a much more intelligent way to spend that. So anyway, let me know again what you guys think down in the comments below. If you did enjoy the video, give it a thumbs up. I would very much appreciate it. And as always, my brothers, don't forget